number one, when you're looking to bring somebody on your staff, is do they fit those values we originally spoke about? Are the kind of person that you feel good about in their values? Do their values align with your values on and off the field? I'm not going to have somebody undressing the players every day with their language and so forth. That doesn't fit me. Now, they're going to curse. It's some people's nature. But, hell, I got a son in coaching. And I remember, at him growing up and always being right there with me every time I called the team up. And when I heard him curse for the first time, I was like, well, where'd you learn that? He said, from you. and so at that point, I changed how I addressed the team. Yeah. I have no question about it. With him being 12, 13, 14 years old, whenever it was, how I addressed the team was different. But I think that's part of it. I think secondly, I want somebody that's an expert at what they do. Yeah. I want, I really do want to try and bring somebody that has an expertise in as a position coach. Now, there's also other people who have great potential because they're a great communicator. Because I think that's the next part. We as coaches are teachers, mm-hmm. and they are a great communicator as a person, and you see that upon them, and you see that down the line, and you can see that vision of them growing to they achieve certain level and so forth. So communication and being able to communicate is so important. I think as coaches, we have guys who are great X and O coaches. We have other guys who can reach inside and pull the best out of the young men. And so you got to have a blend of people on your staff like that.